There may be trouble ahead, but while there's moonlight and music and love and romance, let's face the music and dance before the fiddlers have played, before they ask us to pay the bill and why we still have the chance. Let's face the music and without the moon, humming a different tune, and then there may be teardrops to shed, but while there's moonlight and music and love and romance, face the music and dance.
Darius!
Darius, I thought it was the weakest performance tonight, I'm afraid. For some reason, I just didn't find that believable. I think one person tonight blew everyone away, and that was Zoe. Honestly. And that, to me, I thought was the weakest. I just didn't get it. Sorry.
Ooh. Well, Darius, we're on the final leg of this journey, and when you first came into this search, I mean, I've known you probably the longest out of everybody, and I really, really wasn't sure, but each week you've improved, you've got better, your answers, your performance, everything. You know, you're doing a tremendous job. You've got loads of supporters out there, so yeah. We'll see you this week.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Yeah, let's be honest, Darius, you couldn't be more different from Baby Hit Me One More Time standing there tonight, could you? And, you know, we've said corny, cheesy or unbelievable before. Tonight, I think you were smooth. And smooth is good. Smooth works for you tonight. I think you are smooth and that's your style and it works well. And I think all five of you up here today, with everything in the big band, proves why this is the greatest telly show and everyone's talking about it, because you've all been nothing short of sensational tonight.
Hang on, I need to get in here. Hang on a minute. Simon, you must have something in your ears, mate, because that was as close as I have ever heard to Nat King Cole ever in my life.
Pete,
I have watched this kid.
We criticised
his vocals
people,
tonight
but
were brilliant.
But we were
sorry.
Talk.
I sat
Pete,
here.
Pete.
He is amazing. Pete, I'm sorry. Pete, you can't Pete. Say that that was bad. Go over there and talk to him, Darius. No,
can I just say,
you were brilliant. Go and talk to the lads.
You've had your chance to speak. Thank you for your comments. One of the reasons I'm here is to get your criticism. It's constructive. Thank you. But Simon, I think with your waistband being so high, you might want to undo it one notch because it might be restricting the blood flow to your head.
What's your question, Geraldine?
Question for Simon. As the commercial record producer in the show, did you consciously try and bias the viewers against Darius tonight because you didn't want him to win?
That's a good question.
Good question.
Over
Simon.
To you.
As,
Simon.
As the record exec, Simon.
Ouch. No. You've got to always give an honest opinion, and what I hope is an honest opinion, and I have supported Darius throughout the competition. I was glad that he got in. I think it's very easy to get over emotional at this point because we know them all, and the point was I tried to make tonight before Mr. Snappy butted in was that there were five performances. I happen to think it was good but weaker than the other four. Now if I'm not allowed to put an opinion over, then there's no point in us being here.
I think you disagreed, didn't you, Peter?
Yeah, because I think that it says here, pop idol. Not teen idol, pop idol. Now, what I am fed up with people believing is that anybody over the age of 22 is too old to be a pop idol. And I just think that, you know...
But who said age was an issue?
Because I think it is, Simon, with you, and I think sometimes, you know, you don't understand Darius. We've had this conversation. I didn't come with any baggage with Darius. I've watched this kid grow. And I think tonight, he sang that song and he sang it as good, and this is an amazing statement for me because he's my all-time favourite. He was as good as Nat King Cole
well,
tonight.
If you think,
I thought he was brilliant.
If you
and I think the people sitting at home, you know, They listen and they just hear what they like. And they don't like everything to be up tempo.
Pete, if you think that what I said was about his age, you are talking
We have to.
Let me finish. This has got nothing to do with age, okay? If you don't think that I'm an allowed an opinion, then we won't even bother turning up. It's got nothing to do with age.
I haven't got your. I don't mind your opinion, but you give it in such a way sometimes.
What, like I didn't think he was as good? What's wrong with that?
Because it's the way you said it.
Oh,
and
sorry.
I think that one of the problems is people don't know you well. But people don't know you, so you come across with an opinion like that, and this lady's quite right. It sounds like you've got a different motive. You haven't got a different motive.
No, I've got an opinion.
Oh, Peter. You know, the problem is I see here is you have five people sitting on that couch tonight that are all very different in their own way.
Your problem is you've got too emotionally involved. I'm not saying.
So is everybody at home.
Guys, listen, we're just
I
here.
I think I did him a favour
Don
tonight.
King has been on the phone, and we're going to put this on pay-per-view, everybody. It's going to make millions.